Well, hey everybody, I'm Nathaniel Dodson from Tutvid.com. Welcome right into this Photoshop tutorial where today we're going to take a look at how to mask stuff in Photoshop and why masking is so important. Let's get right to the point, and if you enjoy this tutorial, please make sure you subscribe to my YouTube channel. Let's get into Photoshop. All right, so here we are in Adobe Photoshop, and the first thing I want to take a look at is, what is a layer mask? Well, let's go ahead and just create a solid color layer. This is just a layer that carries a solid color with it. Maybe we'll make it bright red. Why not? Well, this little thing attached to it here in the layers panel, that's a layer mask. Notice right now it's white, because when a layer mask is white, whatever's on that layer, it shows. But when that layer mask is black, if we invert the color of this layer mask by hitting Command or Control I, well, the opposite of white is black. When a layer mask has black on it, the stuff that is on that layer cannot be seen. So what does that mean? Well, let's set this back to white by hitting Command or Control I one more time. And I've got this brush tool, and I'm going to paint with the color black. See, my foreground color is set to black. I'm painting with black, so it's going to hide red when I do this and reveal the image underneath. And you can see I can paint out just an area that reveals them. Maybe bring her arm into play here as well. Now, the cool thing about this is we're not erasing the red. So if the client comes back and says, look, I hate the weird gummy bear looking shape that they have in the middle of this. Can you hide a little bit up here? Well, I can say, yeah, sure. I'll just set my foreground color to white and I'll paint some of that red right back in. And I can do that just like so. So that's a very basic, not super practical explanation of what the layer mask is. I'm going to come over here and I'm going to set the layer mask to solid black. So I'm going to set my foreground color here to black, and I'm going to use the hotkey option delete. That would be alt backspace on the PC. We filled our layer mask with black. Notice also I have this little white selection around my mask. That means I'm working in or on that mask directly. Now, one of the cool things you can do with a mask is you can use a brush or a selection of any sort, but you can use a soft edged brush, and that's going to give you a feathered look. So if I paint with white here, I'm going to use the bracket keys to make my brush giant. And let's say we wanted to have like a red fade coming in up here. Well, I could paint this. You can see how I'm just getting this sort of really strong faded edge, but I can also select the layer mask and I can do something like go filter, blur, and apply a Gaussian blur and say, look, I want you to blur the live-in daylights out of this like to the degree of 400 pixels. And notice what it's doing. I can see here my layer mask, and also I can see the change up here. I'm just getting this red fade, and I could set my solid color layer. Notice now I have the white tick mark selecting the solid color layer. I could set this layer to a blend mode of like, I don't know, screen, and we get this kind of reddish tinge up there in the corner. I could also do something like soft light, right? And there we go. We got a different looking effect. Not quite as good in my opinion. But that's something you can do. I'm going to delete that layer. We're going to come over here and we're going to grab this dog. I'm just going to load him as a selection real quick. And I'm going to grab my move tool and we'll drag him and drop him over here on the bride-groom image. Now he's far too big, but he's just sort of peering in here on the foreground. Rut-row. And we're going to hit Command or Control T and I'm going to just scale him down. Whoop, wrong hotkey. I should be holding Shift and Option. I want him to kind of look like he's peeking out from behind her, right? Kind of like, hey, what's going on out there, everybody? Something like that. But of course, doesn't look very realistic because he looks like he's in front of her and the perspective is all messed up. So what we would do is we would add a layer mask. So we can add a layer mask using the add layer mask icon, or you can go layer, layer mask, reveal all. That just gives you a white layer mask. Honestly, it's simpler just to use the add new layer mask button in the layers panel. And then in here, we can zoom in on the dog and just begin erasing the areas we don't want. So how do we erase it? Well, we use the brush tool and we set our foreground color not to white, but to black. Because remember, black hides. So I'm going to make my brush a little bit smaller here using my square bracket keys. And I'm just going to begin painting the dog away. So I'll paint him away until we're kind of up to the edge of the dress. Now, obviously, it still looks bad because part of the dog is just missing. Well, here's where the beauty of layer masks is. We can simply flip our foreground background color, so we're painting with white, get back to the brush tool, maybe make the brush tool a little smaller, and we can come in here and kind of do our precision painting and just make sure that the dog is painted in exactly along the edge of her dress. We could use a soft edge brush, we could use a hard edge brush, and now he's overlapping right here a little bit. So we can flip our foreground and background color again, hitting letter X. Black is now the foreground color, and I can just paint the dog back a little bit, switch back to white, and just touch that edge up until it's just perfect. So now he's sort of peeking his giant head and body out from behind her. I'm aware the perspective and sizing isn't quite perfect, but this is just an example. Now, another thing we could do is something like maybe we want to change the color of the smoke bombs. We can do something like add a hue saturation adjustment layer. Notice these adjustment layers, they get a layer mask attached automatically. We can just go ahead and swing the hue. So maybe, yeah, you know, maybe we'll make the smoke bomb like pink or something. So there we go. We just swing the hue plus 68. Obviously, the problem is now their skin is green and his suit is that sort of purplish, whatever color that is, and the dog is also green. There's a lot of mess here. So the first thing we would do is select the layer mask and just hit Command or Control I to hide the entire effect, and let's just selectively apply it. Now here's where you could use the brush tool, but we're going to use a different different technique. We're going to try using our quick selection tool and grab a bunch of the smoke. You can see we've grabbed this whole area out here. I'm going to hold down my Alt or Option key and try to just get rid of some of that stuff. Hey, this is not at all going to be a perfect selection. I'm just showing you a different way to go ahead and constrain a mask. You know, we'll just do it to this part of the smoke here because that's going to be nice and easy for this video. You could take this in to select a mask, though, and really refine it if you wanted. And then you would select the mask, and you could fill this with white. Our foreground color is white. Option delete, that'd be alt backspace on the PC, and then select deselect, and you can see we now have that part of our smoke that's purple. If I shut the hue saturation layer off, it's blue again. Now it's purple. So it's kind of it's a really great way to constrain anything you want to constrain. Now, just a couple quick tricks here with the layer mask. You can Alt or Option click a layer mask, and you can view its alpha channel. So you can see here we got these white random streaks. If you wanted to clean that stuff up, you could always take the brush tool. We can paint with black, maybe make my brush a little bit bigger, and we can just paint over that because it's like, yeah, I know no purple should be out there, so just we'll make sure nothing is showing out there. Alt or Option click the layer mask again over here to get back to the image. You can Shift click a layer mask, and that temporarily disables it. See how now we're back to that whole messed up green purple looking image. Shift click it again to make it enabled once more. You can always drag a layer mask down to the garbage to just straight up get rid of it if you want. I'm going to cancel that because I don't want to get rid of it. And lastly, you just want to make sure that you are either selecting the layer mask if you want to work on it or selecting the layer if you want to work on that. So here, if I want to paint on the dog layer and paint white up here, I can paint two blobs of white, but it's there on the dog pixel layer, not in my layer mask. If I wanted to work on the layer mask, obviously I would click on the layer mask. So I'm going to undo that to get rid of the big blobs of white because while they're nice looking, they're not that nice looking. All right, last example I want to give you here for a mask is we want to clean up his suit a little bit. Maybe he's looking at it and he's like, you know what, I should have gone with the black suit for my wedding, not the navy blue. Can you make my suit black? Well, yes, absolutely we can. We can add a black and white adjustment layer here, and we'll maybe darken up the blues a little bit since we know his suit has some blue in it. Now, obviously, the whole image is black and white, not what we want. I'm going to hide the dog because that's just very distracting. Select the layer mask, Command or Control I to hide that, and we need to create a selection over his suit. So once more, I'll probably just go with the quick selection tool here and just create a rough selection over it. And that's fine. We get our rough selection and we can clean this up now with the brush. So now we select that layer. We just want to flip this right from white to black. So we can actually hit Command or Control I, and that will take those areas of the mask in our selection and just make them solid white. Command or Control D to deselect. Now we would zoom in. You can see we've black and whited up some of this stuff. And this is where the beauty of the mask comes into play. You can take your brush tool, make my brush a little bit smaller here. We want to paint with our foreground color set to black because we want to get rid of the black and white effect on some of these areas. Like here under his arm or right here on her arm, we want to get rid of that. We want to get rid of the black and white effect up in here, right? So just go ahead and paint with black in there. Great. I'm going to move up here. This whole lapel did not get picked up by our selection, so hit the letter X. White is now our foreground color. And I can just paint over that with my brush set to white, and we're going ahead and making that part of his jacket. Well, we're making it not blue anymore. I'll put it to you that way. And then over here, a little bit of black and whiteness got spilled onto the background, so we're going to paint with black. And just make sure our background wall has that yellow color. His wrist also should not be gray, so we'll make sure that that's corrected as well. And right up here along his neckline, that should all work. And then I'll come in here along her a little bit and then just clean up her chest area. And then we move back, and you can see that we have created this black and white effect, just sucking the blue right out of the suit, and we constrained it to just that area using this little mask. So masks, they are super duper powerful. You're going to use them all the time in Photoshop. I want to do a quick comprehensive breakdown in 10 minutes or less on how to use layer masks in Photoshop. I highly recommend you check them out, create precise selections, and begin masking instead of trying to use the erase tool. Even when you could use the erase tool, by using a mask, you can always go and just paint black or white and further hide or further uncover whatever artwork or anything that you're working with. And if you're using adjustment layers like this, you need to use masks because you can't erase adjustment layers. And the same goes, by the way, for smart objects. So that'll wrap it up for this one. So there you have it for a super speedy introductory guide on what masking is and why I think you'll love it if you get into it. If you did enjoy this tutorial, consider picking up a copy of my Photoshop course. It's all about how to retouch images in Photoshop. We cover all kinds of masking in there as well, and you'll really, really up your Photoshop game using that course. And you also help support what we do here at tutvid.com as well. And for that, I am super thankful to you. If you are on Discord, consider joining our Discord, discord.me/tutvid. We got a nice little bump in community that we're building over there. It's a whole bunch of fun. And yeah, so for creating masks and selections and just constraining stuff with masks in a very non-destructive way in Adobe Photoshop, that's it. Get it? Got it? Good. Nathaniel Dodson, tutvid.com. I'll catch you in the next one. And before you go, make sure you subscribe to my channel for more great tutorials every day. Also, buy my course. It helps us do what we do, and this channel is supported by viewers just like you.
You can also just click the thumbnail and watch another video from this channel. See you next time, guys.